like the first notification of the list is being made by the president and it can be asked in the prelims exam as well. However, there is no explicit prohibition against the subcategorization. Next news says Supreme Court reservation verdict, Hartal by the Dalit Adivasi groups in the Kerala on August 21. Basically, this recent Supreme Court reservation verdict, which says we need to bring the subcategorization of the castes. You need to understand subcategorization in the context of the Supreme Court. It has defined further classification within the scheduled caste group based on the factor socio-economic status and the historical disadvantages. Basically, rather than just saying this is a scheduled caste, we need to classify them further so that the reservation benefits could go to the people which they require more. It was in news because in the Madiga community, that is the 50% of the SCs in Telangana has faced the challenges because due to the dominance by the Mala community. And in if you will relate it to the basically constitutional articles, because if it appears in the mains, there you have to mention about the articles like in which it can be used, and you need to give the reference like if the subcategorization needs to be brought, then where the amendments needs to be made. So in the Article 341 and 42, it grants a power to the President to notify SC and SC list to Parliament to create to this list. Basically, the first notification of the list is being made by the President and it can be asked in the prelims exam as well. However, there is no explicit prohibition against the subcategorization. So as such, subcategorization is not being prohibited by the Constitution. Next developments, what was there, as the many states, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, they have tried to bring the subcategorization within the caste, but in the past, Supreme Court and the High Court has basically declared them invalid in the context that this power is not given to the state governments to subcategorize the scheduled caste because the list has to be prepared by the presidents. But now the Supreme Court has said subcategorization can be done, and in fact we have discussed already, Justice Rohini committee has been made to bring the subcategorization within the OBC caste, but now the discussion is on the subcategorization within the scheduled caste. Now E.V. Chinha versus State of Andhra Pradesh, under this basically judgment, it has emphasized that the Supreme Court list should be treated as a single, scheduled caste list should be treated as a single and the homogeneous group. It has said scheduled castes are basically homogeneous, they cannot be subcategorized. Earlier in 2020, it was the judgment. And basically, President has the powers to create the scheduled caste list under the 341, and states cannot basically interfere or disturb it, including through the sub-classification. But later in 2020, the Winder Singh case, it has said that basically 2004 decision needs a reconsideration. It means E.V. Chinha versus State of Andhra Pradesh, it was 2004 case. It is said President has only the power to make a list and the state governments cannot basically interfere into the list. But later in the Devinder Singh case, they have rejected the idea of the scheduled caste being the homogeneous. They have said basically concept of creamy layer was also recommended by the Supreme Court for the scheduled caste and the scheduled tribe. So basically, this says the scheduled caste are not homogeneous, so subcategorization can be made. Benefits would be, so in the exam hall, you can't be right the whole negatives or the positives, you have to give the balanced answer as a bureaucrat, because you can only suggest to the government, is the finally mandate of the government to bring whatever it is. So benefit would be, first is the targeted policies, because the benefit of the schemes and the reservation could go to the people which require them most, and the fair representation can be done, and the empowerment and the recognition will be more, as within the scheduled caste there is basically more cultural differences between the caste as well, and the more identification and belongingness can be given to them. But what will be the problem there? Challenges would be, it would create more social divisions, and exacerbating existing social tensions could be created with this, and identification within the basically caste and the verification will be difficult. So there will be complexities in the accurate identification, obtaining the accurate and up-to-date data on the socio-economic status. It will be also difficult to obtain the data, and identification will be difficult, and it can bring the social tensions, and it can become a basically politicization of case can happen, and it can become a populist. It can become the populist agenda, and on this it can affect the basically communal harmony. So observations made by the Apex Court, what could be the way forward? Reservation policy should be organic and evolving, not static. In this article it has been said that Supreme Court has said, as even in the newspaper we see the changing times, similarly basically we have to evolve the reservation policy. Can't be as old as 50 years old, so it needs to revive itself. So way forward could be, policies need to address the specific needs of the subgroups without causing the fragmentation and weakening the collective strength. So meanwhile we are basically maintaining the collective strength of the scheduled caste, but we also have to give the benefits to the people who require them, and criteria should be developed on which criteria basically sub classification will be done, and the data collection and analysis need to be done. The Justice Usha Mehta Committee was set up in 2008. Report has recommended inclusion of the basically 341 article to be amended, and under this empowering the state legislatures to enact the reclassification of the scheduled caste category subject to presidential confirmation. So basically you need to understand, to bring the sub-classification there is a need of the constitutional amendment under the article 341, under which state governments can be empowered, but on this president confirmation has to be taken, and these are the steps to be taken for the basically sub-categorization. The crux is, we need to make a balance between the basically maintaining the collective strength of the scheduled caste, and to give the basically specific, fulfilling the specific needs of the subgroups.